What's up, everybody, and welcome to The Safe State, a channel about all the things you love in nerd culture. I'm your host, Landon Barton. I've got Johnny Nitpick here.
Hello.
He makes some awesome YouTube videos, and you should check it out. We'll put a link right over his face again, because that's what we like to do. Just put the picture right here, all up in his face. So, anyways, Nintendo just had a Direct on April 1st, which I kind of thought was going to be a joke at first.
Yeah,
it
yeah.
was legit. It was serious.
Did you see the Twitter post they made about it?
No, I think I missed that
They were like, we have a Nintendo Direct tomorrow, and it's not a joke.
It's not a joke. We're being real. What'd you think overall? Like, we're going to break down point by point kind of what they announced, but was it a good Nintendo Direct or was it kind of a lackluster Nintendo Direct?
I was pleasantly surprised. I kind of thought that there was going to be... I know we've had a few Directs, right?
Yeah.
Where there's just been a lot of filler.
Oh, for sure.
And
absolutely.
It's just a whole bunch of stuff that I just really didn't care about. But with this Direct, I feel like they really condensed it down to everything that really mattered.
Yeah. I mean, there was definitely some stuff that was like, eh. But overall, I thought there was some really nice stuff that got me excited, and it's... They need to do this because their market share is so small now.
Yeah, seriously.
So
I was glad to see it jump with the DNA thing. So
yeah, absolutely.
That helps a lot.
So one of the first things that they announced was their new Amiibo lineup,
right.
Which they also announced. So they got Dr. Mario, Zero Suit Samus, Splatoon, Inklings. You've got the little yarn Yoshi,
which was
adorable. I thought that was super.
Don't even get me started, dude. I am so stoked for that thing.
Yeah.
Well, as soon as I saw that, I was watching it with my buddy Caleb. As soon as I saw that, dude, it makes you almost forget about all the other Amiibos.
Right.
I don't know about you.
Yeah.
I like that it comes in three colors too.
Yeah. No, it's great. I mean, they definitely know their market, and they know that the people that are buying these Amiibos are collectors.
Right.
And they want every single version of this possible. So it's like, all right, cool. We're gonna put this special Yoshi yarn Amiibo, and there's gonna be three of them.
It's so cute, and the fact that there's, I don't know, I like that it's more out there. It's something I didn't even expect them to do.
Right.
Like, make it out of a completely different material than just
it's
plastic.
Yeah.
It's great.
Because now they've got, you know, you've got the Smash Brothers lineup.
Yep.
You've got the Super Mario Brothers lineup.
Right.
And now you've got this yarn lineup. And
yeah.
They also announced that, so DLC characters like Mewtwo and Lucas?
Lucas, yep.
Lucas, yeah. So they're going to get their own Amiibos too. So, I mean, that's got just fan material all over it.
One thing I have an issue with as far as all the different Amiibos is just like game compatibility in general. And
it's
I don't
weird.
Know how long they're going to be able to keep it up with like trying to include every single Amiibo. But Mewtwo and Lucas, I mean, I can see Mewtwo being used in Pokemon, right? I mean,
right.
Pokemon's huge. I can see that. But Lucas...
where else is he going to be used for?
Exactly.
Except for, I mean, I think they're trying to combat that with... This was another point that they announced was... Your Amiibos can unlock these short 3-minute demos.
Right.
So I think that's going to be the only other, for certain characters like Lucas, that's going to be their only other second function.
Really. I know, that's freaking depressing.
So it's weird. I think it's more just on a collector's market at this point.
Absolutely.
So maybe later there'll be something else. Maybe they'll add some more little small goodies like those 3-minute demos or
another
whatever.
Mother game, maybe?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. God, if they did that.
Fingers crossed.
If they did
Fingers
that,
crossed.
That's insane. So the other thing that they announced was Mario Kart 8 is getting a 200cc speed, which, are you excited about that?
Oh my God, yes. I have to admit, the one thing when I'm playing Mario Kart that I want is for it to just be a little bit faster, and when they announced that, oh, it blew me away.
That is definitely not the one thing I want from Mario Kart 8, although that I'm really excited about that,
right,
because that's
going to
be really fun. I want a better battle mode for Mario Kart 8.
Oh.
The battle mode in Mario Kart 8 is shit.
It's freaking terrible.
Don't kid yourself. It's awful.
Yeah.
It's so bad.
That was one thing I was hoping that they would do. So, because they announced all these DLC packs, and I was like, you know what they're going to do? They'll probably make, like, 3 battle courses with each one of those packs, and they didn't do that at all.
No. Oh, man. So, let's see. The other thing they announced was Mario Kart 8's Animal Crossing DLC will arrive early on April 23rd. So, that's cool.
Oh, yeah.
You know? Anytime it's coming early, I'm all right.
Exactly. In Nintendo, I don't know. I feel like with like the delaying of Zelda and things like that, I feel like this is kind of...
Panic mode.
Do you think... I don't know if this Direct was sort of like a last-minute decision because of everybody panicking about Zelda. I don't know if that's... That could be like a theory. I don't know.
I don't know. I think the production value and the amount of time that has to go into a Direct, mm-hmm. I don't see that being a quick decision.
They were pre-planning it?
I think they were pre-planning all this stuff. It doesn't... But they also pre-planned ahead of time.
Yeah.
That Zelda was going to
exactly,
be delayed as well.
Exactly.
So they knew ahead of time. It's probably still is panic mode, but I don't think that it's like a, oh shit, people are upset.
Yeah,
let's do
yeah.
this now.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think a big company like that can make decisions that fast.
But right.
That's just my opinion.
But yeah, I'm super excited about that Mario Kart DLC, especially because I think they said it was going to be released late May, I believe was the first time they said.
It was forever away in the original.
Yeah, I know, the time in between the DLC releases kind of confused me to start.
I think it needs to, between that and the 200cc, I think it's going to get people back into wanting to care about Mario Kart 8. Because right now where I'm at, I've got everything unlocked in Mario Kart 8.
Yep,
like,
me too.
Myself and my fiance, like, we're obsessed with it. Whenever something else happens on it, we're like, all right, well, let's get that and let's just go into it. So the other thing that Nintendo announced was Animal Crossing Happy Home Designer. You get rid of all the tediousness from a traditional Animal Crossing game and you just get to make fancy houses. But the cool thing with this is it's the first time that they're going to be using the card-based amiibos.
Right.
So, are you excited about card-based amiibos?
I have absolutely I have zero interest in getting a card-based amiibo. I used to be a card collector. Pokemon, Yu-Gi-Oh, sure, Magic, whatever you want to call it.
I still am a little bit.
But like, I don't know. The only reason I like to collect cards is because I could play card games with them.
Sure, right. If they had some other functionality other than just, especially, I don't know what the pricing is on this either.
Yeah,
like, are you buying an individual card? Are you buying a pack kind of a mystery pack? Like, there's still a lot of questions that maybe they've answered that I just don't know.
Now, if they package them in with, like, amiibos or something like that, like, oh yeah, here's your Mario amiibo with a random card in it.
That would be awesome.
That would be okay. I'd be cool with that. Yeah. But, like,
you should do that, Nintendo. That's a good idea.
If it's, get a demo and a card every time again. That's awesome.
No, that's great. I love that idea, actually. That's really great. Okay. This is where I'm excited
about.
This
is you. Yeah.
Shin Megami Tensei is getting a... They teased it, I don't know how long ago, but a crossover with Fire Emblem.
It's like a year ago, I think.
Yeah, and then nothing. Nothing forever.
Yeah.
And then they show up here, and they show this teaser trailer with no branding at the front end of it, so you're like, what is happening right here? I'm like, these characters, it kind of looks like the Fire Emblem style.
Yep.
But like, those characters kind of look like Persona or like Shin Megami Tensei branded characters.
Right.
What the hell is this? And at the very end, it's like, oh, this is a Mega 10 crossover with Fire Emblem.
I had no idea. The person I was watching it with was like, what are we watching right now? Yeah. I was like, I don't know, something anime.
Yeah. It's for the uninitiated, it would be kind of weird.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm very excited, but I don't think it's going to be a thing that's going to sell systems. It's going to be, it's again one of those niche things that's going to make very specific people really
happy.
Yeah,
the hardcore fans will love it.
But it's not going to sell systems. But I'm excited about it. Yeah. I love that trailer. The trailer was so cool.
You heard it here.
Yeah.
Landon's day one purchase.
Absolutely. I was really confused though when they first started showing the trailer. I was like, I don't know what
I was like, do they have like their own TV show they're making now? This is pretty cool.
So they also announced another one of their more affordable games, in the same way Captain Toad was only like $40 when it was brand new. So they announced Puzzles and Dragons Super Mario Bros. Edition. So this is, are you excited about this?
This is a series I know nothing about. I know it's, from what I hear, it's super huge in Japan.
Yeah, I'm sure.
But I don't know anything about it at all.
Yeah. But I don't know if there is an American, I would assume maybe there was like a DS or a 3DS version of something like this, but I don't know.
I think so.
So.
But again, man, I just know nothing about it. But I'm pretty sure, doesn't it come bundled? Like you get like the Mario version and you get the Puzzle and Dragons version, they
all
come bundled together.
So you're basically getting two games for like $30.
Yeah.
So that's going to be really the only reason why I would pick this up.
Yeah. Are you going
to
get it?
Maybe. It's going to be one of those things where it's like, I don't have a lot of stuff for the Wii U to play.
Right.
Because there's not a lot of games, period. You know, so this is going to be an affordable title. It's going to have Mario in it. It's going to be made with Nintendo. Like, it's probably going to have a lot of care and heart into it.
Absolutely,
so it's like, it might be fun. It might be terrible. So I don't know.
I think it's gonna be good. I read up a little bit on it, not enough to really know a lot about it, but I've heard it's a great series, so I'm sure people are gonna love it.
I think the key here is that it's one of, if they're affordable games,
exactly.
It's to get it in there where it's like, all right, well, it's kind of an impulse buy for a console, which is kind of weird, but I don't know.
It's a good way to get in though. Yeah, absolutely.
They also announced a new Fire Emblem for the 3DS.
Right.
So if you love Fire Emblem, there you go, another game.
Pretty much. I don't know exactly what's like really different about this one.
What's really different about this is for the first time you get to pick sides in a big army. So you get to pick, I can't remember the names, but if you pick the family that is, they wear primarily white clothing and they're supposed to be if you pick that family, you get a traditional Fire Emblem experience. So something that you're used to, nothing really new, just if you want that traditional Fire Emblem experience, you're gonna have a great time if you pick that family. And if you pick the other family, it's supposed to be much more difficult for you. It's supposed to be kind of a different, unique experience, a different side. They're not supposed to be like evil per se, but their motivations aren't nearly the same as the other family. And so it gives you, so A, right off the bat, you get replayability.
Right, yeah.
Play the entire game on the one
like
side.
Two
play
games
the entire,
in one there.
Exactly. And they're supposed to be very unique experiences too, which is important rather than just like, okay, I get a different side, different take on this story.
So like you're going to totally be like battling at different locations and stuff?
I guess
we don't know.
Yeah. But it's, so the Hoshido side is the traditional good side.
Okay.
And then let me see if I can find. Oh yeah, the Noor side, N-O-H-R, is the darker side, though, where you get the different, unique, new experience. So that sounds pretty cool.
Well,
If you're really into Fire Emblem, it sounds like you're gonna get.
Yeah, Awakening was great. Yeah. Awakening was a great game. So I'm pretty sure this is gonna be fantastic.
The other thing that they said, which is great, that Nintendo is actually listening to fans, because a good game that's out on the 3DS right now is Codename Steam.
Right.
And a lot of people had issues where when the enemies would take their turns, things bogged down. You know, it would go really slow. The enemy, they would have to sit, because you'd have to wait. You would take your turn, and the enemies would take your turn, and take their turn, and you had to watch all of their animations, all of their attacks, and it would just take forever. And so finally they added an update where on a regular 3DS, you can fast forward 2x speed.
Oh, good.
If you have a new 3DS, you can fast forward like 3 or 4x speed.
Nice.
So just taking advantage of the faster processing and everything. So they're listening to fans, which
is great. That's great. Didn't they reintroduce the Marth Amiibo too for that game?
Yes.
In particular?
I forgot about that. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I was going to say that.
So that's good.
I wonder if they're going to do that. That made me wonder like if they're going to be doing that with like Villager and probably not Wii Fit Trainer. I mean, I don't think there's a huge demand for Wii Fit Trainer.
Unless they're really wanting to combat scalpers at that point.
Yeah, pretty much.
So, new Fatal Frame is coming out for the Wii U. Are you excited about that?
Yes.
I will be doing a Let's Play
on that the minute. I'm gonna grab that the minute it comes
awesome.
Out.
Awesome, that's cool.
People keep asking me to do a horror game, so.
Okay.
But,
do you like the horror games?
Oh yeah, I love horror games. I've never played Fatal Frame before.
Oh really?
Have you?
Yeah, I played some old Fatal Frames, but horror is not my genre.
Really?
Yeah. So
too scary or what?
I just don't enjoy them. It's not that they're too scary. It's just I don't necessarily enjoy them. There's certain ones like Silent Hill. Like I'll play through those just because the world that it builds is unique enough that I can get past the fact that I don't really care about horror games and just want to experience whatever this weird
the atmosphere is where it's
at. I was really excited about Silent Hills just because of it's the names that are behind it,
right?
You know, so
Kojima
and Del Toro, like, so
absolutely.
That's gonna be one of those experiences where I'll get past my bias towards horror games and play it just because of who's behind it.
I think that game is gonna be earth-shattering, but Fatal Frame. I've heard good things from. I know a couple people that import games because it was Japan exclusive for a while.
Yeah.
And now it's finally coming over to America. But I know a couple people that import games and played it and said it was very, very good. So
good.
I'm really excited.
That's awesome. Let's see. So Nintendo 64 titles are finally coming to the Virtual Console, which is good. And also, if the game supported Rumble Pack on the original 64, you've got Rumble features now on the Wii U. So. You love your 64 games.
One thing I had a problem with that was like it just seems like it took forever for them to do that.
Yeah.
I don't understand.
Well, emulation for a Nintendo 64 is always kind of a hard thing anyways too.
Right.
So I think it's probably a lot of that issues.
Well, I think they announced that around when the Wii U came out. They said they were gonna start doing not N64 but DS titles.
Sure.
And then it just dropped off the map, and I didn't think that they were ever going to do it, but then I'm glad they came back.
Looks like the pricing structure is about 10 minutes a game.
Yeah, it's decent.
$10.
10 minutes, It's decent. It's decent.
Let's see. What else? Mario Maker's coming out in September, so that's cool. Mario Maker's going to be a good game.
Yeah, can't not get that.
Let's see. We already covered the Yoshi's Woolly World Amiibos.
What'd you think? You watched the Direct, right?
Yes.
What'd you think of how Woolly World looked?
I think it looks great.
Like, I mean... From what I was watching
like
of it,
or just visual quality.
Both, actually, because have you played Yoshi's Island, the Super Nintendo?
Man, a long time ago. I never beat it, but long time ago.
I consider that one of the greatest games on Super Nintendo.
It's beautiful.
Oh yeah, absolutely. And I think that I like that they're doing the a different art style with Woolly World too. But it makes me. I was watching the trailer for it, and I was like, this just seems like it's kind of easy, from what I was watching.
Yeah. Well, but didn't they say in the Direct that this game will be challenging?
Yeah, they have a beginner mode and a serious veteran mode, which is interesting.
So the final thing I want to talk about.
Okay.
they announced that you can, they can take your suggestions on who you want to be
Fighter
in
ballot.
Smash Brothers.
Yeah.
So, to close out this video, I want to know, who do you want to be in Smash Brothers?
King K. Rool.
Oh, nice.
I've been wanting King K. Rool since the N64 version so bad.
Yeah.
After playing Donkey Kong 64 and then playing Smash Brothers, that's the guy I wanted in the game since the beginning.
What about outside of Nintendo? If you could have anybody else.
Outside of Nintendo. Oh, that's a good one.
I've definitely got an answer of who I freaking want in any fighting game, period.
How about Rayman?
Ooh, Rayman is actually a really great answer, and that's probably feasible.
I know.
That'd be feasible.
Since Ubisoft is the closest third-party developer to Nintendo.
Well, I mean, because they've got Mega Man in there, they got Sonic, so I mean, yeah, why would Rayman not be in there? I want Goku. Give me Goku.
Yes.
Put Goku in Smash Brothers, and that's going to be the greatest thing in the world. I'd be so excited
about that.
Just
decimate every single fighter.
Yeah. So there you guys have it. Let us know in the comments below, who do you want to be in Smash Brothers in a Nintendo franchise or outside of a Nintendo franchise? If you guys like this video, please give us a like and a subscribe. It really means a lot to us. As always, you can find out more from us. We're on Facebook at facebook.com/thesafestate, and we're on Twitter @_safestate. We've got Johnny Nitpick here. His channel is freaking awesome. Go check out his stuff. Again, click his face. His face is the important thing right here, okay? We'll see you guys next time.